Okay. I need to bring Aether back for Gaia. Varl and Zoe are waiting for me by the west exit. But I could head back east first. Check on how Plainsong's doing after the attack. Or I could also look around here some more.
Are you sure?
Yes. I think it'll be better this way.
That's no good. Can't use the pole caster on that. Door won't open. Guess Gaia hasn't been able to restore access yet. Door won't open. Guess Gaia hasn't been able to restore access yet. Oh, I've been down here before. It's where I first got into the facility. Gaia, it looks like all the stuff down here connects to the dome. What's it for?
This facility was designed to process an immense amount of data from the terraforming system. This is where it would have been stored. Aloy, you have now visited all accessible rooms of the facility.
Looks like some kind of storage room. Gaia, what is this?
It is a control console for a drone-based imaging system connected to this dome. I will transmit the relevant data to your focus.
Huh. So this Cyclops is a network of drones to monitor the deteriorating biosphere conditions. I guess it was meant to display on the dome, but the drones aren't connected anymore. If I find the drones out in the wilds, I could get the data from them, use it to reconnect them, and restore the display.
Error. Data missing. Error. Drone offline. Error. Drone feed disconnected. Error. Drone feed disconnected. Error. Drone offline. Error. Data missing. Error. Drone offline. Error. Data missing. Error. Drone feed disconnected. Error. Drone feed disconnected. Error. Data missing. Error. Drone offline. Error. Data missing. Error. Drone offline.
Hey, Gaia. I'm back.
So I see what is on your mind.
The extinction signal didn't just wake Hades. It made every subordinate function self-aware. Why?
I have wondered this myself. So far as I can tell, Hades was the sole target, and the partial sentience imparted to other subordinate functions was incidental.
So the signal could only have been sent by someone who had thorough knowledge of the system, huh?
Yes. The signal's design was exceptionally precise and highly advanced. Were its intentions less malevolent, I would admire the intellect or intellects that produced it.
So if the descendants came to Earth on a spaceship, I guess we can assume that their technology is powerful in all sorts of ways, right?
Yes. As your encounter with them at the Proving Lab amply demonstrates, they appear to make extensive use of robotic servitors. Further, they seem to be equipped with some kind of protective energy field that shields them from harm.
Yeah, no kidding. The one I fought seemed indestructible.
Throughout history, every defensive technology has eventually been defeated by an offensive counterpart. Perhaps a way can be found to defeat their shielding.
Yeah, I hope so. Or I'm not going to be winning fights against them anytime soon. How did you figure out that the extinction signal came from Sirius?
The key came with data on your focus. From Silent's interrogation of Hades. The duration of the signal itself, 17.22 years.
That doesn't make sense. You said that the signal took 8.6 years to arrive from Sirius. Why would the signal keep transmitting after it was received and you blew yourself up?
Because the sender didn't know that had happened until it received notice from Hades.
Which would take another 8.6 years to get back.
Correct. Only then would the sender stop broadcasting, after a total of 17.22 years. So the duration, halved, gave me the distance the signal traveled. With that in mind, I simply scanned my astronomical database for any relevant location 8.6 light years away. Because it was Far Zenith's intended destination, Sirius was the only logical source.
The descendants I ran into at the Hades Proving Lab, they had a clone of Elizabeth Sobek. So that's consistent with the idea that they came here to salvage Zero Dawn technologies, right?
Yes. As your own experience demonstrates, a clone of Elizabeth Sobek functions in effect as a key to the terraforming system.
But how could they have made a clone?
The Odyssey carried approximately 200,000 human zygotes, millions of animal zygotes, and billions of plant seeds. It is conceivable that Elizabeth Sobek's genetic material was sampled, with or without her knowledge, and carried aboard the ship in storage.
That's... okay, but... I mean... This clone... How could she participate in this? Destroying Elizabeth's dream? It's evil.
It is difficult to know. Perhaps she is loyal to the group and shares their objectives. Or perhaps she is a subordinate and has no choice but to comply with their orders.
Elizabeth Sobek? A subordinate? I don't think so. The sole purpose of the signal was to destroy life on Earth, right? Why would descendants of Far Zenith want to do that?
At this point, we can only speculate.
I mean, Earth posed no threat to them. We don't have the technology to get in their way. We didn't even know about them.
True.
Unless... well... could it be that they want the planet for themselves? The strangers I ran into, they were after a Gaia backup of their own. I mean, if they did that... if they booted their own Gaia and boosted her power... until she could take control of Hephaestus. And then the whole terraforming system.
Then yes, The system could be used to do what the extinction signal failed to accomplish. Snuff out life, and then potentially to build an entirely new biosphere to their specifications.
So they could be trying to do the same thing we are.
But with opposite results.
Extinction instead of salvation. Well, this is not good. The missing subordinate functions. What can you tell me about them?
Artemis rewilded the Earth with a variety of animal species. Eleuthia was responsible for gestating, nurturing, and acculturing a new generation of human beings. Apollo was tasked with preserving, organizing, and disseminating vast archives of human knowledge and cultural achievements. Unfortunately, all archived Apollo data was purged on the 2nd of February, 2066, by order of Ted Pharaoh.
Pharaoh, huh? I really hate that guy.
Understandable. He appears to have been pathologically narcissistic, impulsive, and unstable.
All three of the missing functions have already served their purpose, or were prevented from doing so. Do you still need them?
If attainable, yes. Restoring their remaining elements would increase my heuristic processing density. Unfortunately, I have no way to track them. They have disappeared without a trace.
See you later, Gaia.
Until next time.
Drone feed disconnected. Error. Drone offline. Error. Data missing. Error. Drone feed disconnected.
Traveled high up the mountain since entering the sacred cave.
It's hard to say.
Can't tell if it's day or night in here either.
I need to head further west. To, get more of Gaia's components. Make her stronger. You two can stay here in the meantime. Gaia can help get you up to speed. I'm not trying to shut you out. This, it's like training.
Actually, I'm gonna go back east to get Erend. Bring him here. Look, allies, friends can help. We have a place to stay now. And like you said, Gaia can teach us, catch us up. It'll be okay.
Okay. Take these then.
One to wear, one for backup.
While you're at it, stop by Stone's Echo and look for Milu. Give her a message for Talana that I found a way over the mountains.
Will do.
Are you going with him?
No. After what happened in the cave below, I want to stay here a while. There is much I need to understand. Maybe by the time you get back, I'll have a thing or two I can teach you.
Looking forward to it. When will you be back?
I'm not sure. But hopefully I'll have one of Gaia's missing components with me.
Be careful out there. Even in Plainsong, we heard how the Tanakhth clan lands are suffering from storms, machines, and now Regala.
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine.
Good hunting, Aloy.
The Tanakhth clan lands. Somewhere out there's three of Gaia's subfunctions. And who knows what else. Snow's melting on my clothes. Great.
Thank you.
Oh, Aloy. Your Karja friend came through. She went to that Oseram camp you two were looking for, to the southwest. Aloy.
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you. You sure you're okay being alone in here?
I have Gaia. And learning how to interpret the glyphs of the old ones, it keeps me occupied.
Have you gone back to Plainsong at all?
I thought about it. But I wouldn't know what to tell them. The chorus already thinks me a thorn in the thicket. If they knew what we did to Fa, even if they understood, there'd be little they could grasp about all this. No. For now, I must leave the tribe behind.
You mentioned you've been teaching yourself how to read?
Yes. Gaia was kind enough to put together a list of glyphs used by the old ones. She helped me decipher some of the data you've collected, and showed me how to use the focus to help the process. It's not easy, but it's been working so far.
That's good to hear. Sounds like you met my friend Talana.
Yes. The Karja Huntress. I haven't seen armor like hers since the Red Raids. But Varl tells me that she too suffered at the hands of the Mad Sun King.
Yeah. She's one of the good ones. Trust me. Did Gaia tell you anything about the Zeniths?
She did. Though it wasn't exactly easy to believe. To think that there are places among the stars where life can bloom as it does here, it is humbling, to say the least, and heartbreaking. That such life should be bent on destroying ours.
So, how does a tribe like the Utaru manage to maintain the peace with warriors like the Tanakh?
By holding them off. When our fields bloomed aplenty, the Tanakh looked upon our lands with envy. But Plainsong's dishes provided sanctuary and high ground to keep invaders at bay. In the end, even the Tanakh saw sense in a truce. The Utaru promised to provide the Tanakh with food from our crops every year. In exchange, the Tanakh would relinquish one of their own, a veteran, to train the Utaru in combat. This custom was abandoned a few years after the derangement. But some veterans still remain in the plains.
I've been meaning to ask, what's the deal with you and the chorus? You didn't seem to be on the best of terms.
That's what happens when you're the one Utaru who insists on publicly defying them. Twice. When the Karja invaded the Utaru plains, they did more than just attack our villages. They burned our fields, took our people as slaves, and murdered those who were too weak to make the trip back to Meridian.
To be sacrificed in the Sun Ring.
I was helping the healers back then, as waves of refugees swarmed into Plainsong. The chorus was divided in how to face the invaders. Some saw sense in raising arms. Others believed the dishes would keep us safe, as they had many times before. And while they bickered, I buried the seeds of the fallen.
You called yourself a grave singer. What does that mean?
To all living things, an end must come. It is my task to ease the passage. I try to bring comfort and sing of the renewal that death sows the way for.
I need to go, but if you need anything, you can contact me through your focus.
I'll keep that in mind.
Going down. Send it to my stash.
Thank you. was a waste of time. Regala had better send those reinforcements.
Should use shock ammo.
The embassy. Can't wait for more.
I know you're out there.
I swear. I've been awake for too long.
At this rate, Hakara will be left with weak wings and bare-armed scabs. Regala will take the gold. I'm sure of it.
Grass here.
You see her?
find this in my stash later. Soon enough. Get this from my stash when I need it. Good time to pull out shock ammo. Well, we'll have to worry about running out. I'm out of this ammo. The Atari man got. What's it doing here? I think that's one of the Utaru land gods. What's it doing here? This will be in my stash when I need it. An Otaru shrine. I'm not sure what it means.